On this week's Xamarin Show, I have my good friend David on, talking about the brand new Flex Layout in Xamarin.Forms 3.0. Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and I'm really excited to have my good friend David Ort now, Program Manager for Xamarin.Forms, back on the show. How's it going, David?
It's going great, James. How you been?
I've been amazing. It's beautiful here in Seattle, Washington. It's just awesome. And we have so much new, cool awesomeness that your team has been working on. So I was like, I got to get Dave back to be on the show.
I know. It has been a while. We've got a lot going on. I keep hearing people in the community say that we've got a great pace going. So that's good feedback to hear. They're happy with what we're delivering.
That's awesome. That's good. Yeah, so maybe for people that don't know who you are, can you give them a really, really brief 101 overview of what you do here at Microsoft?
Sure. So at Microsoft, I am a program manager with the mobile SDKs, focusing primarily on Xamarin.Forms, but also working on iOS, Android, and with the components team. So what that means is that I'm working on determining what is of most value to you who are using the product. So I'm talking to you about what you do with the product, where you're struggling with it, where you want to see it grow, and bringing that feedback back into the team, working up solutions, making sure those solutions are actually going to meet your needs, and hopefully delight you and make this the platform that you love to use. So that's really the whole goal of what I'm doing here at Microsoft.
Beautiful. So I know that the team's been working on a lot. What are you going to show us today?
So today I want to talk about the new stuff that we shipped at Build, primarily Flex Layout. So it's a new layout system that we have. You can continue using Stack Layout, Grid, Relative Layout, Absolute Layout. All are still fantastic. But what Flex Layout brings to the table is something that a lot of web developers have been enjoying for a long time, which is a layout system that is really good at adapting to not only various screen sizes, but also with distributing and spacing content within those layouts.
Okay.
So what we're looking at here on my screen right now in Chrome, we've got a wonderful dock. The docs team has done a great job with this here. And then I'll just show you real quick. They've got some pretty cool demos here. But I've cooked up a couple of my own demos that I would love to show you and walk through kind of how I myself learned this and explored it and show you what the properties are and what you can do with this sort of thing.
Yeah, absolutely. So some great documentation, great samples already. But yeah, I like to see it in action. So let's take a look.
Exactly. So what I have here is I've got my flexibility app. This is up on my personal GitHub. We can link to it. And this is just several different pages that I feel are kind of representative of what people generally do in apps, and certainly things that I look back at other apps that I've built, apps that I'm continuing to build, and I build these kinds of screens. And I said, how would Flex Layout help me do these things better? So the screen that we're looking at right here, this is an achievements grid, right? So these circles that you see in the preview over here would be, little trophies or whatnot that you might get. And so what's happening is in my layout, let me scroll down here a little bit. You'll see that I've got this Flex Layout inside of a scroll view. And then I've just got a bunch of these user controls, custom controls that represent these little trophies over here.
Got it. Now this looks like to me, like we potentially could have 100 trophies, many more trophies.
Yeah.
And if I was to do this normally, I'm thinking that it looks very similar to a grid layout where yes. I'm specifying columns and rows. But what I see here is you have this Flex Layout and you're just shoving things into it. So how is this kind of working and knowing how to lay these out?
Yeah, absolutely. So Flex Layout has rules that determine how it's going to space and lay things out. So I'm using something else that we shipped at Build in Xamarin.Forms 3.0. And this app, just for reference, is using Xamarin.Forms 3.1. So 6 weeks after Build, we were all ready to start shipping a new version. Very excited to have that new pace up and going. So by determining or by setting these rules, so currently I'm in a row direction. So it's going to space things out in rows. So let me do a couple of things here, and I'll show you what happens when I start removing things.
Now, this is CSS, right? This is inline CSS, but it could be XAML properties too. You could use either of them, correct?
Absolutely, okay. Absolutely. And I've got some other styles in here that are XAML styles that are being used. So you can mix and match CSS with XAML styles however you want to. Quite a bit of overlap, but because Flex Layout is a web-originated concept, it made a lot of sense to start bringing CSS in as well.
Cool.
And we learned, you know, again, I talk to customers. That's the primary thing that I'm working on doing. And so I learned that a huge amount of our customers are coming from web backgrounds.
Oh, so they're probably already a little bit familiar with CSS and some advantages too that they cascade, right?
Right. And you know, we're looking at XAML here, which comes from a desktop paradigm. And so we tend to think that we cater primarily to a desktop audience. But in reality, when we looked at our actual user base, we determined 50 to 60% of our users were actually coming from web.
Oh, interesting.
And had minimal desktop experience. So this has been a very welcome feature. So you can use it, you cannot use it. It's entirely up to you whether or not you're more comfortable with XAML styles or CSS. But you'll see what I did here is I pulled out the wrapping on the Flex layout. Now I've got just one row.
These are properties, essentially, like inside the CSS that you would be setting?
Yeah, so I could come down here, but I could also do the same thing here. And I could say, okay, I want to set my wrapping here as well. And it goes back to what I had before.
Got it.
And the inline CSS doesn't have all the wonderful IntelliSense you would like to have. If you actually go out and use a separate CSS file, you do get that, which is nice. So if I can look at a couple other things here. So the main things that I wanted to call attention to on this page are the flex direction. So the directions we have here are column and row. So if I set that as a column, boom, it's just one column. But you see that it's not wrapping, right?
Yeah, so if it's I come just literally back and I, bop, 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 down. That reminds me of like a list view almost.
Yeah, and so you look at that and you're like, well, that's kind of like a stack layout, right? Yeah. And there definitely is a lot of overlap between what you can achieve with one versus the other. But where things generally leave off when you're using a stack layout, flex layout is just that much more robust.
You can
start doing a lot of really interesting things. And as I progress through these three pages I have here, you'll see that it gets pretty, pretty interesting. So I'll go ahead and put this back the way that it was, put it back to a row. The other thing I wanted to call attention to is this justify content. So, you know, I mentioned that it's not just about distribution, but it's about spacing of the child elements.
Okay.
And so what is happening here is it's looking, it's measuring the space around each of these circles. And it's saying, how much space do I have available to me? Let's even it all out. Right.
Yep.
So, space around, whoops, I just jumped. Space around is one. We can also have everything go to the start.
Ah.
Or we could have everything go to the end. Or, I believe, center. Yep. And then, so not only do we have space around, but we have space between. And you'll find that these, you see how it spread everything as far wide as it possibly could, and then put all the padding, all the extra space in between the inner elements. So depending on what your layout is, that might be really useful to you. So this is a great way to explore this, pull down these samples. So now the one thing I will point out is that, as you noticed, I'm just slamming a bunch of things in here. And so when you see yourself slamming a bunch of the same things into something, you say, well, I want to be able to data bind that, right?
Yeah.
Flex layout doesn't currently have the item source, doesn't have the binding mechanism to it. But if you go look at the Conference Vision app, which is what I used for all of my demos at Build, and that's up on Microsoft/Conference Vision on GitHub. It has an example almost identical to this, but I'm using a repeater element that extends off of Flex layout. And
now,
so you can data bind to that.
Let me ask you a question, David. Like, so right now you have all of these achievement views that you've created, but then Flex layout, can I just put like anything inside of it? Like, what if I just wanted a button or a label or something else? Like, can it be, do they have to be the same element?
Do not have to be the same element. So let me skip to the third one and I'll show you something that includes a variety of different things, but it's all inside of one Flex layout. So you see, we have an image, we've got a bunch of labels. We got a couple more images. We've actually got a custom font going on here with the stars. And then at the bottom, which you can't see because I pushed it off the screen, let me grab these guys and get rid of them. You see, I've got a couple of buttons down there.
Got it.
It can be anything. This is another really exciting aspect to Flex layout, because these rules are so flexible. I mean, it's very aptly named. It's flexible. it promotes a flatter layout. And the reason that that's important is because when you're measuring things and you are laying things out, you want to not recurse up and down a UI tree unless you absolutely need to. So the flatter you can make your UI tree, the more performant your apps will be laying out, especially on those older Android devices or those slower iPhones. You want to make sure that that especially your high-performing stuff is as flat as possible, and Flex Layout kind of promotes that for you.
Yeah, that's nice because I know I'm really used to essentially going through and creating a stack layout and another stack layout and then something else and then something else. And then it kind of gets this really jumbled mess of attempting to figure out where are my elements, what layouts are they in. But it seems like I can just have everything in one layout.
You can. Now, then the question becomes, well, am I breaking some kind of unwritten rule by nesting flex layout within flex layout within flex layout? And you're not. You do whatever you need to do to get your layout to work, right? In some of my layouts, you'll notice, not necessarily in this app, but in other apps, that I'll have a flex layout with a stack layout. And it might all be inside of an absolute layout, depending on what my needs are. So don't be afraid to go use other stuff as well. This is just a new one that we've introduced because it fills some other holes and is a bit more useful across the board. So
use it when you need to, just like you would use grid or stack layout or relative layout when you need it. It's just another tool in your toolbox.
Another tool in the toolbox. So I opened up here while we were talking my CSS that goes along with this page. So instead of inline CSS like before, now I have a separate CSS file. And I load that up in my resources by calling style sheet up here and referencing that CSS file. And over here, you know, as I mentioned before, you don't get the good help and IntelliSense that you would want inside the inline stuff, but you do get that here. So you can do start and end and center and all those sorts of things.
Oh, very cool. Very nice. So you can kind of mix and match if you want. Again, all completely optional, which is nice.
Yes.
Yeah, and it seems like this is a very complex layout. So really different use cases here, but really controllable. It seems like you said very flexible layout to do all sorts of crazy things. Almost reminds me of the recycler view on Android at some point.
Okay. Yeah, so a couple of other properties just to call quick attention to. Align items and align content are a couple of other rules that you can play with to tell the children, hey, where should you be going when I start wrapping and doing different things like that. And then flex grow and flex shrink can become very useful to you as well when you want to make sure that the measurements don't suddenly squish your button, for example, out of existence.
Okay.
So I had that happen to me on one of my layouts. I was working on it and I'm like, why is my button not showing up? Because I had another element that was growing and it was taking over the space the button was supposed to have. So the way to solve that was to put a shrink of 0 on it. And that basically said, don't shrink at all. No matter what the other elements do, you don't shrink. Take up the space you need. So those are a couple of other cool properties to be aware of. So here's another quick example that accentuates one more property. Let me open this window here. So got to have our monkeys, right?
Oh, yeah. Look at that. In fact, I believe that one of those photos, if not many of those, are my photos.
You know, and people who are watching may recognize some of those photos as their own. And that's because, with the thanks of Google Images, these are the images in my layout.
Beautiful.
So, so these are all social media posts. But the one that I wanted to call attention to here is the basis. So you'll notice this flex basis, I'm saying for this CSS class of full, I want it to take up 100% of the space available. Mm. What basis is doing is it's saying for that element, this is the base size that you can be. It can be screen pixel, device unit measurements, or it can be percentages.
Okay.
And so that's how you see in this layout, this first row, each of those takes up about 33%. Well, that's because that's the default here on the photo. It's 33%. And so all I'm doing here is I've got, again, a bunch of images. They don't have to all be the same element as we mentioned before. But when I want one to take up all the space, I just add that additional CSS selector for full. And that now takes up 100% of the space. And that's how I get this one second row image taking up the whole size. And you can create some pretty interesting flowing layouts. I mean, these things, this is still flowing, right? It's not physically positioned or anything like that.
Yeah, that's really nice. I mean, in my mind of even attempting to do this previously would take a lot of time to kind of understand. But once you kind of seem like you get the grasp, even here, it's not really that much complication either. You just have like some percentages of, and it seems like it's really pretty straightforward.
Yeah, it makes, for me personally, my own personal bias, it makes a bit more sense to me than grid does. Mm. Grid has traditionally been what we promote the most because it is highly performant. The algorithm on it is excellent. But, you really need to understand the intricacies of a grid and think in that way this for me personally makes a lot of sense. I can think in percentages, and then you start to get a handle on align items and shrink and grow and things like that, and you can accomplish some cool stuff. So yeah, so this flex layout for you.
Very cool. Well, David, this has been awesome, and I'll be sure to put a link in the show notes below to not only this sample, but also the great documentation and all the samples there. David, this has been awesome. I'm really excited to actually start using it in a bunch of my apps, because a lot of my apps ship on not only phone, but tablet and all different places. And this works everywhere, every platform.
It works everywhere, absolutely.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, David, thank you so much for coming on and sharing the Flex layout.
Right on, thank you.
Awesome. Well, until next time, this has been another episode of The Xamarin Show. Don't forget to subscribe and ding that bell for notifications so you get updated for each and every Xamarin Show. Until next time, thanks for watching.